non-payment to service providers, equipment shortages and staff shortages. These are the issues we are all aware of, but the consequences affect patients and doctors every day. Here are their stories. A 23-year-old Johannesburg woman lost her baby, she says, due to negligence. She arrived at Chris Hani Baragwanath Hospital late last year to have a cesarean section. When she arrived at the labor ward, she says she was shocked by what she saw.
When I got there was like 50 women in the labor ward.
After a total of 18 hours, she was finally taken to theater, but it was too late.
Only got to theater at 9:30, 18 hours later.
And what?
With no heartbeat, the child was fresh stillborn.
The hospital has come under fire for staff shortages, but she says it's more than that.
They couldn't be bothered, you know? They just couldn't be bothered. If there's beds, there isn't. If there isn't, there isn't. Some women give birth on the floor. That's how bad it is.
A Pretoria resident says he's been waiting for a hip replacement at Steve Biko Academic Hospital for over a year.
They tell you the waiting list is 3 years. And, you know, to have a hip that's deteriorating fast and you have to wait for 3 years before you can have the op is not, you know, I don't think it can be seen as acceptable at all. Because they told me, as I said, more than a year ago, I needed the op.
Other patients there had to stop radiation treatment for their brain tumors. There are long queues at the pharmacy, and many don't get their medication because the hospital runs out of stock. This situation isn't dissimilar to what is happening at Joburg's Charlotte Maxeke Hospital. The lifts have been broken for months and medical stock is not barcoded, meaning there's no track record of what has been used or not. Patients say the implementation of the National Health Insurance System won't change anything, saying even if the funds are available, the services aren't, and people will continue dying unnecessarily. Doctors have told Eyewitness News they've had to write to the health ministry in order to get urgent intervention. Sometimes even necessary antibiotics aren't available in wards. There's a shortage of bandages and even toilet paper in some of the hospitals. Staff are demotivated and patients are desperate, with the situation seemingly deteriorating. Even delayed payment to suppliers has become such a common problem that many doctors have just thrown in the towel, saying they cannot save lives under these circumstances. Is this a story that will be told year after year? Health authorities denying that there's a crisis. Serious questions have been asked as to whether the health department and officials have the willingness and know-how to turn around a public health care system, which has often been described as shocking. In the past year, Gauteng Health MEC Ntombi Mekgwe has faced stern criticism and her department has been streamlined by her boss, Gauteng Premier Nomvula Mokonyane.
It's easy to think that more money will bring about change, but what about poor management and staff motivation, and who is accountable? In the past year, it appears that things have worsened under Gauteng Health MEC Ntombi Mekgwe's watch.
It's still a team's effort, but somebody must account at the end.
So do you believe that you are accountable?
I'm a political head. I account politically.
This way.
Gia Nicolaides, Eyewitness News.